Big 2 Weather Authority forecast. We warned you first.
All right, joining you now, forecaster Kaylee Hunt. And Kaylee, let's be honest, it's a little more humid than we like here in West Texas today.
Definitely. It was extremely humid today, and it was like that all day, not just in the morning, but throughout the whole day. And I'm sure most of our viewers know we saw a whole lot of good rain yesterday. Now, I did make a play through the viewing area yesterday around 2 p.m., but then it kind of lingered around till about 9 p.m. Now, we didn't see a whole lot of rain today, but we did see some high dew points, but we didn't get a whole lot of rain. And actually, temperatures were up in the mid to lower 90s. Mid to less as high was 93, but take a look at Wink. 100 degrees in Wink, 101 in Pecos. Definitely a warm day. But here's a look at the temperatures right now. Now, we're not in the 90s, and while we're not in the 100s, we are looking at temps in the mid to lower 80s for most of the viewing area. Mid to less is at 84, Big Spring 83, Fort Stockton 84 as well. But like I said, we saw a whole lot of rain yesterday, and because we didn't see any rain today, well, that's why we are actually warmer today right now than when we were right here 24 hours ago. Mid-Odessa, 10 degrees warmer, Wink 14, Pecos 19 degrees warmer right now than at this time yesterday. But seeing how low it's going to get overnight into tomorrow morning, well, we're only going to dip down into the mid to upper 70s, meaning yes, it's going to be an extremely warm day, and well, later on by 5 p.m., most of the viewing area will be in the mid to upper 90s, if not the hundreds. Mid-Odessa will only be at 99, but Big Spring already in 100. Wink 102, Pecos 103, definitely going to be a very warm day. But here's a look at the dew points. Now, they have been relatively high throughout most of the day, and overnight into tomorrow morning, that's not really going to change. They're still going to remain in the mid to lower 60s, if not the mid to upper 50s. So what that means is, yes, there is a lot of moisture in the air. So as you're running errands and headed out outside, you're going to notice it's not as dry as what we're used to feeling. Even throughout the day, later on into 5 p.m., dew points really aren't going to drop all that much. They're still going to be in the mid to lower 50s, if not the mid to upper 40s, so it will be noticeably just a little bit more warmer. But here's a look at the wind speed right now. So yes, gusts were up there in 30 mile per hour here in Mid-Odessa, 26 in Wink, 20 in Pecos. Definitely a very windy day. However, overnight into tomorrow morning, well, the wind speed is actually going to decrease for most of the viewing area. Mid-Odessa will just be in the mid to upper teens, 14 miles per hour. Mid-Odessa, Big Spring, 15. Even south of I-10, it's still going to be in the teens. And then throughout the day, well, it's actually going to decrease for most of the viewing area into the single digits. So in the morning, yes, it's going to be windy, but then later on, well, it's going to die down. But tracking to see if we're going to get any more storms in the forecast. Well, we are looking at a little bit of isolated storms right now in southeast New Mexico, but that's going to clear out. And so overnight into your morning, it's not going to be a whole lot of storm activity, not going to be a whole lot of thunderstorms at all. Even later on throughout the day, around 3 p.m., still not any storms making its way into our viewing area. Until later on, around 9 p.m., that's when you may see the storm wipe its way down. But here's a look at our drought monitor. Now, with all of that rain, it did do us some good, but we could still use just a little bit more. But like I've been teasing, tomorrow is definitely going to be another warm day. In some parts of the viewing area, we'll get into the hundreds. Midland and Odessa is forecasted to be 100 degrees, definitely warm. Make sure you're staying hydrated and trying to stay as cool as possible. Even in the mountains, which tend to run a little bit cooler, we'll still be getting into the mid to lower 90s. Now here's your look at the 7-day forecast. And yes, tomorrow is going to be in the hundreds, but good news for people who don't like triple digits. It's not going to be in the hundreds for the rest of the work week, just teetering in the mid to upper 90s. Now I have to ask, yes, it was relatively humid today, Caleb. Did you like it?
Oh, well, I'm kind of used to it since I'm from Florida, but you could definitely feel it out at Firecracker Fandango. I was sweating pretty hard, but, you know, that's the way it goes when rain comes, right?
Exactly, exactly. We needed rain, so that was good news.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Kaylee.